So how do I feel about the questions about the butt wink? I don't have too many emotions to them. I'll give you my thoughts, okay? So a butt wink, which is often confused with the loss of lumbar. Let me see if I can pull a butt wink out here, okay? So normal squat, we're here, okay? A butt wink is when you see the pelvis tuck under. You guys see that? So I'm there and the pelvis tucks under, but my lumbar curve stays locked in. Now, oftentimes we get confused because we can see a 1-2 punch where I'm here and then the pelvis tucks under and I round. Do you see the difference? Okay, now it's a rounded back as opposed to here, but the pelvis tucks under. It's not necessarily a point of performance loss. It can lead to, okay, but it can be from super tight or overdeveloped hamstrings, blah, 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 blah. The goal is, think about it, if we are losing it because we're disengaging, how do we engage the hamstrings more? What cue did I give you, Amanda?
Drive your knees out.
Drive your knees out and push your hips back, that's right. Or if you're too low, what cue did I give you? Stand up, because then you engage your hamstrings.
So,
yes, so when it comes to pelvic tilts and things like that, be mindful, because that's how we can lose midline, right? So we don't want to do this, right? So that's, and that's a loss of midline, certainly when we start, like I gave you that cue overhead. So that's when we just simply tell them what? Squeeze your butt. If you squeeze your butt, it'll put it right in line. So those are some cues to help you there. As opposed to getting too into the weeds, try to just get them to do what you want by giving them action. Hips back, stand up, squeeze your butt, something like that. Does that make sense? Great question. Does that help? Awesome.